And now, ladies and gentlemen, please put your hands together and welcome to the stage, Paul Gilbert.
Rock and roll. I want. thank you so much, everybody, for coming tonight to New York City at the Iridium. And we're going to carry on with the tune right now. This is a difficult intro, so I got to practice it once to get it right. Got it. All right, here we go. One, two, three. On the keyboards, Ashley Falero. nice jam right there. I enjoyed that very much. It's still pretty much in tune. All right, well, we're going to carry on. We've got more songs. We've been practicing, so I'm going to talk less and play more. I'll still talk a little bit. All right, the next one, I like this one, but this one requires a new guitar. Give me a second. This one, if someone said heavy metal, there is more heavy metal in this guitar because the magnet is stronger. It's that satisfying kerchunk when you put the slide magnet on there. And this one, what can I tell you about this one that's interesting? A lot of the songs, I'm playing songs from my new record tonight called Behold Electric Guitar. Thank you very much. And I wrote these by singing. That's how I wrote them. But I'm performing them by playing guitar. So this one originally started its life as a vocal. Actually, the last one did, too. The last one was a song called Having It, Don't Make Me Stop Wanting It. I was just singing Having It, Don't Make Me Stop Wanting It. And that's where it came from. But this one is... I had this idea that, I don't know if you guys know the Easy Beats, Friday in My Mind. Monday morning feels so bad. Anyways, listen to that. I thought it was kind of a cool riff. So I came up with my own version, my own notes, my own melody. Slowed it down a little bit. My lyrics, what were they? My battery's low, but my mind is high. Put the phone in my pocket, take a look at the sky. I really don't care, let that battery die. And that's the name of the song, Let That Battery Die, and it keeps on going. But I'm going to play with my slide guitar, and I'm going to let Asher do the duka duka part. Here we go.
Yeah!
it took me so long to figure out that I could sing with my guitar. So if anybody's a guitar player out there, I'll save you years. Just try singing with it. It was really nice. All right, so let's see. We got this one. Can I handle it with this one? I think I can. All right, this one, I got to tell you a little story. This is about my, I think this was a nervous breakdown. I'm not sure. Do you really know? Like, what's the dictionary definition? You know, all I know is I just lost it at the airport. I couldn't take it anymore. I sunk to the ground in sadness and frustration and humiliation. And I was just sort of a sobbing mess because I had missed my flight and I was so tired and jet lagged. And it was my fault, but I didn't want it to be my fault. I wanted it to be someone else's fault. And the poor lady at the counter had to deal with me, and she finally just said, "Sir, you need to calm down." But she said it with a high voice, "Sir, you need to calm down." Anyway, that was what was told to me, and I realized I better, that's good advice. So I wrote a song around it, and when you hear the middle part, the funky part, that's me singing, "Sir, you need to calm down. You need to calm down. You need to calm down, sir. Sir, you need to calm down. You need to calm down. You need to calm down, sir." So that's where this tune came from. And maybe a little bit of Batman. So here we go. This one starts out with the crazy thing. I think I need the other guitar for the crazy thing.
So much suspense.
Because this is a crazy thing here in this key of C sharp. Thank you. this one for you right now. This one's in the key of E. And this one is another story. I was in Los Angeles. I was shooting a video with my band, Mr. Big. And when you shoot a video, the first step is you rent a warehouse. Because if you're in a band, you always look cool if you're playing in a warehouse. And so we got one. We took all our stuff there. And the man who owned the warehouse was there. And he loved his building. He was so excited to show us all the rooms. You know, we only were playing in one little small part of it, but he was like, you got to check out the upstairs and look over here. And I could tell this is a man who loved his building. And I thought, I just was inspired to write a song about his love for the building. So I wrote something like this, like, one, two, three, and I own a building. And it feels so good to own a building. Got my name on every brick, an extension of my... And that's where I had to stop. And the walls are 2 feet thick. Anyway, I thought, I can't, you know, these lyrics are really going to a place I shouldn't go. So I decided, again, to play it instrumentally. And let's see how... Yeah, I think this will be all right. I'll use my slide magnet. So this one's called I Am a Building. It's got one part in it that happens a couple times, and it's a weird part that really has nothing to do with the rest of the song, but that's kind of why I like it. And we're going to start with that part. Let me remember how to play this because it's crazy. Okay, I think I got it now. I'll do a little slower than that. I'm so good to own a building. Oh, this is a burning one here. This one, when I was 6 years old, I quit the electric guitar. Actually, I quit the guitar. I didn't have an electric one yet. Quit the acoustic guitar. And the reason I quit the guitar was because my teacher showed me this melody. And I thought, I don't want to play that. And to have to work to play that, that's not what I wanted to do. I wanted to play rock and roll. And he wasn't showing me rock and roll. He was showing me that. So that made me quit guitar. Later on, I picked it up again on my own and learned other stuff. But for the longest time, that melody was my nemesis, my foe. I did not like that melody. And I thought, years passed, and I was writing a song, and I was writing this cooking groove and lots of funk stuff and lots of fast things in it. But I thought, it needs a melody. I thought maybe, and of course, if you Google Mary Had a Little Lamb, and you can find out that it's public domain, so you can use it for free. And you don't have to pay any publishing to anybody. And so I thought, well, maybe I could have my way with Mary Had a Little Lamb. And so I did. I put it in this song, and I reharmonized it a little bit with some of the chords. And I kind of like it now. So I've made friends with my old nemesis, Mary Had a Little Lamb. And this song is called Everywhere That Mary Went. And it starts off on this note. But that note doesn't last very long because we play it quick. All right. 1, 2.
Thank you.
keyboards, Ashley Fulero. This next one is one of my favorites. It's about the snare drum. Does everybody know what the snare drum is? That was after I quit guitar when I was six. I bought, well, I don't know if I bought it. I was too young to buy anything. My parents bought a snare drum for me. And they told me, like, this is the sound of rock and roll, the snare drum. And I took the Haskell Haar drum method. I learned how to go ti-ti-ta, ta, ti-ti-ta. And I gave that up, too. It was like the drum equivalent of Mary Had a Little Lamb. But little did I know the power that was waiting inside the snare drum. And this song's about the snare drum. And let me just sing the lyrics that, again, you know, it started, the song began its life as a vocal song. And it goes kind of one of those, is it like a jig? Or? Well, I can get up in the morning, even when I'd rather sleep. And I can pay your expenses when everyone else is cheap. And I can take you so serious while everyone else plays a game. But I can't listen to music where every snare drum is the same. So it's a song about drum machines and how I'd much rather hear a human being playing the drums. So thank you, Bill, for playing, for being the human being tonight. All right, it begins with the snare drum. Take it away.
Thank you.
on the snare drum,
Bill Ray.
All right. Well, the next song is, what began its life is a very sad song. I had written a lyric, and I was in one of those sad moods. The whole world was against me, and nobody liked me, and I felt so blue, and, you know, I just have the blues forever and ever. And it never stopped, and just everything was wrong, and you know, sometimes you get in those moods. And so I decided I'm going to write the saddest lyric I can ever write. And the title of the song was Love is the Saddest Thing. And it had all kinds of other lyrics about sad things. And I thought, okay, now I just got to come up with the appropriate sad music so everyone is sad. And it'll be so sad. And so then I sat down with it, and I thought, you know what? I would probably feel a lot better if I changed the music to be like this cooking shuffle that was really up and optimistic. So I tried that, and it worked. And I was no longer sad. I was sort of cracking up, going, this is pretty funny, and I kind of like this tune. So it's nice when music can do that. You know, I saved the $300 to the therapy visit. And I came up with a tune. So this one's called Love is the Saddest Thing. You can hear me playing it on the slide. You know, I'm going with it. You know, love is the saddest thing. But, you know, it's cooking behind it. So, you know, even though that's the lyric, it's the music cheered it up. But here we go. I'm going to play it. Cook and shuffle. One, two, three.
Oh,
impossible to be sad when you got that cooking groove. All right, this next one. If you're a guitar player and you bend the string once in a while, you have to do a guitar face when you bend the string. You can't just go. You gotta go. It's just the two things are hooked together. There's like a fight going on when I'm doing. Because the face part wants to come out. Anyway, I really enjoy making guitar faces, and so whenever you got to take pictures to put on the album cover, so I was doing that, and I was looking at the pictures trying to figure out which one is the best picture for the cover, and I found this one. I thought this was pretty good, and I was holding the guitar up in the air and making a face, and I thought, well, what could be the title? And I thought, well, what does it look like? And I thought, it looks like a snake just bit my toe. And I thought that could be a song too. So I've been playing a lot of slide lately, and the blues. This picked all. I need a new one. Sure. So the slide is kind of built for blues in the same way that bending is too. And so I thought I'm going to come up with a real down home. Snake just bit my toe. That's my Paul McCartney look in Blackbird. He goes, into the land of the dark black night. I'm going to steal that one, put it in somewhere. Anyway, this one's called Snake Just Bit My Toe, and it goes, one, two, three.
Bye. right, this next one. I always wanted to be a Beatle. That was my biggest dream when I was a kid. That was not alone. Many people wanted to be a Beatle as well. And, of course, my name is Paul. So that could be helpful. And, let's see. I play guitar like George. I've got a Japanese wife like John. And if I try to sing, I sound a little bit like Ringo. A little help from my friend. But anyway, I wrote this poem, and I found whenever I read it that it didn't sound right if I just recited it with my normal speaking voice. But if I read it as Ringo, it sounded much better. And that's what I had to do whenever there was a T, the letter T in the middle of a word, I had to pronounce the T. Because in America, we soften them to a D and we say things like metal, but it's actually metal. Or bottle, but it's really bottle. But anyway, that's the one thing I had to learn to fix my Ringo and make it hopefully as good as possible. And and the other thing, I got to remember the words, and hopefully I'll do it. All right, but this song is called A Herd of Turtles. And we're going to play it slow once because it's really fast. And I want to make sure I got the notes right before we do the fast version. We're going to do the slow version first for The Herd of Turtles. Let me make sure I remember how it goes. See, it's how's it go? It's an A. Okay. I think I got it. So now we're gonna make it cook.
One, two, three.
Turtles. What's the next line? Saw a herd of turtles. Do you remember the next line? I saw the herd of turtles going fast as they could go. I asked them, what's the hurry? They told me they don't know. But swimming in the ocean had turned into a bore. So off they started walking in search of something more. We walk, we crawl, we know there's something there. We feel it, we believe it. Don't you know we need to follow this crazy dream? And yes, I totally understand what they mean. Of rabbits all holding knives and spears. I asked them, what's the reason? They told me about their fears. We are tired of being eaten. We're tired of being chased. So next time there's a fox around, we'll put him in his place. We'll fight, we'll stand. We know that we can win. We feel it, we believe it. Don't you know we need to follow this crazy dream? And yes,
I totally understand what they mean. Staring at me in the mirror. I asked why he's still playing when he can barely hear. He pointed to his forehead. His mouth is grinning wide. I listen to the music that I can hear inside. I play, I sing, I love with all my heart. I believe it, I feel it. Don't you know I need to follow this crazy dream? And won't you understand what I mean? Thank you very much.
In 99 and one half day.
minute, something's wrong. My key won't unlock this door. I said, wait a minute, something wrong. Something wrong. My key won't unlock this door. I got a bad, bad feeling that my baby don't live here no more. That's all right. I still got my guitar. Look out. Something to say on that piano right there? Give me one bonk on D. Roland, you got something to say? Two bonks on D. Bill, you got something to say? Sister Will.
I appreciate that very much. Thank you so much. All right. This is our third night here at the Iridium. We'd like to thank everybody here for letting us play. And every night we try to do at least one song that's different than the last, do something a little special for you. So tonight we're going to play a song we've never played before except in soundcheck, but it sounded pretty good in soundcheck. And this is actually maybe what started this whole trip I'm on of trying to play vocals on guitar. And this is, when I first tried it, I thought it's just impossible, that I'm not going to be able to do this. And actually, I still do. There's one vocal lick that is impossible, at least to get it sounding anywhere close to the original, and that's in this song. And that just, only David Lee Roth can do that. And, you know, you can't even touch it with any instrument at all. That's just, but anyway, I'm not going to try that one. I'm going to try a song by Janis Joplin. And she sang it just by herself in a foot stomp. And there was no other instrument. So I had to make up the chords. And I figured out something. Hopefully I got something that she would approve of if she were here today. But I love this tune, and it's called Mercedes-Benz. And I'm just going to play it by myself once, then you guys can come in. All right, so here you go, Jan.
Ladies and gentlemen, let's hear it one more time for the incredible, the phenomenal Paul Gilbert. Thank you for coming out tonight and supporting live music here at the Iridium. Make sure to check out our website, www.theiridium.com, for information on upcoming events, such as Billy Gibbons, Carl Palmer, and Joan Osborne tomorrow night. On behalf of myself and the whole staff, I wish you a good night and a safe trip home. Thank you.
Good morning, little schoolgirl. Can I go home? Can I go home?